Hello and welcome to Tekkit. You may be aware of the Technic pack in Minecraft. Well, Tekkit is the multiplayer version of the Technic pack. It's in beta still, so it's not perfect, but me and Rillian and Shin and a few of our friends have been playing this a lot the last few days. We've just like hardcore played this game. We've been playing it vanilla, so we haven't been cheating, we haven't been spawning stuff in, we've been building everything from scratch, which has actually been surprisingly fun. First of all, I'll show you how to download and install Tekkit, and then I'll show you around kind of what we've done and what's possible to do. I'll get Shin and Rithian to show you what they've built, and then I think I'll do a few kind of basic tutorials on how to get started in Tekkit. So yeah, I hope you find it interesting, because I'm a massive fan of this mod. Now that it's multiplayer, I think a lot of people are going to have a lot more fun with it, competing with their friends. We have a kind of rivalry going on our server between the magicians who use equipment exchange and the scientists, which I count myself as one of, who I use the kind of sciencey Buildcraft and industrial craft mods. So let's get going. So, to install Tekkit, you go to www.technicpack.net/Tekkit and you click here. Client is downloaded through the launcher, so you Windows or Mac. If you want to run a server, there's a link for the server file here, but just for the client, it's this Technic launcher, which you'll then need to run. Just put it on the desktop for now. Now this will bring up the Technic launcher, which is like the Minecraft launcher, but it's for Technic pack. First it will download all the bits it needs. Okay, and then once you're on here, you've got the options of the Technic pack, Vanilla Minecraft, or Tekkit. Tekkit is the multiplayer one, so I pick that. I put in my details. And press Login. Now it will download Tekkit. This is completely standalone, so you can still have your normal Minecraft install, and this won't interfere with it at all. To play Technic pack or Tekkit, you just run everything through this launcher, and it's basically a different game. Once that's all downloaded, it will launch the game for you, and you just you can play single player or multiplayer if you've got a server up. And there you have it. That's pretty much it. It's very easy to install. There's no dragging around of class files. You just run the launcher and you can play. So yeah, so this is my house, and I will show you currently what's possible with Buildcraft and industrial craft together, mixed in with a little bit of equipment exchange, but not much. I haven't really touched upon that much yet, because this mod is so big, it would take a long time to learn everything. But yeah, so where to start really? You need power. To do anything in industrial craft or build craft, you need to produce power. So I have various sources of power. I've got this this solar generators here. They collect energy from the sun. And this is my nuclear reactor, which produces energy from uranium. It's actually nearly run out there. To replace those cells soon. This produces the majority of my power, but I subsidize it with various other sources just in case, you know, something goes wrong. God forbid. This is a combustion engine battery, I like to call it. It produces a fair amount of power, but you have to convert it back and forth between industrial craft and build craft, because there are two different mods and they produce two different kind of powers. But luckily there's things in the pack, such as this box here, which convert the power between the two mods, so you can like use the two mods together in conjunction. What else have I got? I got this at the top of my roof here. This is a wind turbine. It just generates energy based on the wind. Now, what to do with that energy, I hear you ask? Well, this is a quarry. It's pretty big. There's actually three quarries. These two are finished, and this one is currently working. As you can see, it's pumping out lots of stone and dirt. Anything it picks up will come out of this tube, and that will be taken through underground pipes to my house. Let's just use my... I should show you these. I've got this cool armor. These items are extremely expensive to build. This helmet means I don't have to eat food. I can breathe underwater. The jetpack obviously lets me fly, as you've seen. These legs let me jump higher, which I don't need to because I've got jetpack. But they also let me run really fast. And the boots make sure I take no fall damage, so I can drop from fairly high distances and take no damage, and run really quick, as you can see there. So that's definitely worth investing in, just because it makes life very convenient. Another thing is these electric tools. They're basically, the chainsaw is basically an axe, and a pair of shears, so you can trim your sheep with your chainsaw. Got a diamond drill, which is like a diamond pickaxe, but better, and a spade. And my mining laser. Now this is fun. I'll show you a little demonstration. Let's go into the quarry. No, let's not. It's full of water. Let's just go straight down into the ground. So, if you hold down one of the keys and right click, you can change the mode. So I'll put it on a low focus, which is the lowest energy consumption. And as you can see, it just shoots blocks. You know, pretty basic, but it works on everything. Anything you shoot it with. It's a great way to mine, it really is a great way to mine. But also, you know, you can set it to long range, which just goes far through lots of different blocks. Or horizontal, just goes straight, you know, pretty boring. Scatter, now this one's devastating and pretty silly. I better get a bit deeper actually before I use that. Just use the mining, which is the kind of basic. It goes quite far. Ooh, let's put a torch down. A bit dark. Now, we found a cave, so this is good. I'll get my laser and I'll put it on scatter. Now this is just mad. Watch this. Ooh, some uranium. That uses quite a lot of power to do, but it's, you know, it's very fun. And then there's explosive, which is, I think you can probably imagine what that is. There you go. Ooh. Makes a big hole. And then you can collect all the stuff. Yeah. So yeah, you can see how it will be easy to mine a lot of areas. Also, with the jetpack, you can just get out of anything. Assuming you don't hit lava or water. Just fly up and shoot and you're out. Oof, there we go. Safe and sound, hopefully. I've yet to be caught out. Using the mini-map, you can make sure that you don't come up in water. And this is how it all works. The stuff from the quarry comes in through this pipe. It's taken to these diamond pipes, which sort it, essentially, into different places. The stone is put into these recyclers, which in turn turn it into scrap, which is fed into this chest. Got a lot of scrap. The mud is put into this equivalent exchange box and is turned into obsidian over a long time. Everything else is taken along here and sorted again. The gems are taken into this chest, and the ore is taken into this, sorry, this way, into this macerator. There you go, it's done some iron. The macerator turns an ore into two dust. There you go, one, two, and each dust can smelt into a bar. So by macerating an ore and then smelting the dust, you can essentially double the amount of bars you get. And then that's pumped into this chest. So it's all very automatic. I don't really have to do anything, I just set the quarry up and it goes, and I get chests full of goodies. The scrap can be used in this thing, it's called the mass fabricator. I'm gonna turn that on. It will fabricate mass. And this mass is called UU matter. And I've got lots of it here. And using UU matter, you can make pretty much any item you want. So if you go into a crafting bench and play with it, you can make it into a square, which will make a diamond. It's pretty handy. It's pretty much what you want to use it for, really. If you make it into an eye shape, it makes an ore called iridium ore. There you go. Iridium, and that is the only way to get iridium ore. And iridium ore is used to make the armor I'm wearing. So it's quite expensive to make. The mass fabricator uses an awful lot of power, so it's, you know, it's, you can't leave it on all the time. I mean, you can see my power level's draining from 10 million, which is max. So that's pretty much my setup. In the next episodes, I'll show you around Shins, and we'll talk to him about it, and Rithin as well, just to see how their setups differ from what I've been doing. And then I'll do a few little tutorials about how to get started, because it is very complicated to get started and quite daunting for a new player to get into the Technic pack. Yeah, so I'll see you next time. Goodbye.